may natanggal. Sino yun? Na mabalik naman lang ito. Sana all in Miss Nabor at Resort. Nakaunan man eh. Okay lang ko at Resort. Sosyalan. Ito ang liwat si Kapukyan at Hapuan, Outer Space. Balik na lang, hindi kung diyan na mapasok Earth. Okay, so, as I've said, bulos na lang ka muna na girls kasi, boys, this is your time to shine. So, this afternoon, our discussion will focus on the prostate cancer. So, kung may magpapakian na next week, may chapter test ba? Kasi kailangan tapusong tamuna ang mga pelvic cancers. So, itatong gindi-discuss na yung pelvic cancers. We don't have to disregard naman yung mga gyni cancers kay halibro iba ang gyni, iba ang pelvic. Alang manikadto sa gyni and prostate, dire man pwede kay panlalaki man, di ba? So and prostate in kadto niya sa pelvic. So ang pelvic cancers and aton magiging discussion diyan, prostate cancer, renal, of course the kidneys and urinary bladder cancers. So next week, mano lang muna tayo, mag-chill lang muna tayo next week. Paray muna kita chapter test because we're going to finish the renal cancers. Dari pa kung maaram next week ha, kung online pa kita ha, depende kung ano, kung mapasupay kalibutan, di ba dapat kailangan itong solusyon at pagiging mapasok yung classroom, di rin man kayo online class. Mas nagpapasok lugod kay, di rin ka mo nakaka-connect. Diri ka mo nakaka-answer maupay kay napuputol ang signal sa mas mainit, diba? Dapat ang long-term solution natong gidaan kailangan aircon na unutan. But anyway, sa true, diba? So kailangan ganun long-term solution diri kay pa online classes tapos wala nga ni mga load, wala nga nga hata ang load. Sana, pero pabura akong guys because adi kabalay. But anyway, so this afternoon, again, our discussion is more of the prostate cancer. So, mabulos na yan ang mga babae. For how many sessions kasi sa Rantera, permanentera na, ano, eran gindi discuss. So now, let's talk about prostate cancer. Alam, may siya kayo ha, magpakianak ang mga girls, may napakang prostate cancer, waray kang prostate cancer. So, kung dati ang mga lalaki pwede magkamayadahin breast cancer o di ba nagko-contest na ako kay nauran talaga di biya amon guys. So kung dati kung nag ang mga lalaki pwede magkamayadahin breast cancer, ay look ka mo girls, may kamot sa mga gusto niyo magkamayad ng prostate cancer, wala ka mo prostate. Ang prostate adala sa mga lalaki, ano? So we all know that the prostate encroach the neck of the urinary bladder. Kaya sometimes the manifestation of prostate cancer is ano, it's likewise na ma-manifest siya sa pag-ihi ng lalaki na may prostate cancer. But anyway, so let's start. So prostate cancer is the most common cancer in men older than non-melanoma skin cancer. And it is the second most common cancer death in American men, exceeded only by lung cancer. And it is responsible for 10% of cancer-related deaths in men diagnosed with prostate cancer. So for prostate cancer, 98% survive at least 5 years, 85% survive at least 10 years, and 56% survive at least 15 years. So if we compare these statistics to lung cancer, mas darodak po ang survival rate for prostate cancer. So if again, for our lecture purposes, so if this is the urinary bladder, on this part that encroach the neck of the urinary bladder, nandyan si prostate. So this is our discussion for this afternoon. Ito siya, si prostate cancer. So kung may mga kilala niyo na nagkamayadan prostate cancer, tapos modern era mga risk factors, so we don't want to create debate. Kay halimbawa, may mga almost na magpatayan sa inuman, diri daw, kay halimbawa, masaring nga, nakaka-prostate cancer ba ang pag, ano, sige masturbate, sige ganito, ang damo ang sex partner, So kasi libro, waray talaga siya magbanggit. Ay, maso ko rin Mark Juday, salamat. So waray habuk magbanggit niya, ano, pag halimbawa, you have multiple partners that you can acquire prostate cancer. Sa book, walang ganyan. So, well, nalipay talaga yung Mark Jude. Parang gusto talaga niya magpakpak talaga. Pati niya talinga, mapakpak. Safe. Oy, Oreo, ikaw ito na lang. Kala ko ano ka. Kala ko behaving. Now showing ka na yan, Oreo. Okay. Nasyakla ako. More likely ang tino. Nagawa na ang true color. Adi na pamati ko may. Ambot siguro. Automatic. Direction ko ni Oreo at to, kaya pag nilalaw ka ni Oreo, parang ano lang, parang silent type. Una ko may nakakapot ng ibang cellphone. E ano, una ko nakakaputi gaspan. Okay, so, again, so, ano, hataas ang statistics ng survival for prostate cancer. So again, 98% survive at least 5 years. Well, at least, may himok at 5 years, di ba? 84% at least 10 years and 56% survive at least 15 years. So, what are the risk factors for prostate cancer? So here, we said that prostate cancer is common in the United States and Northwestern Europe, but it is rare in Asia, Africa, Central America, and South America. So the worldwide incidence, so sige, ay salamat, buti na lang, adi kami Asia, rare talaga siya. So the worldwide incidence of prostate cancer is highest in African American men. Naka kay kuan di ano pag African American men, like ano ba, like mga black, di ba black? Pero kan Oreo black. Ano kan Murillo black yung taas ng incidence. Ayun, si Sir African si Oreo yan. African ladder siya, African American. So pag atas ang incidence ng mga Black Americans like Can Murillo, wow, at least Murillo pumapasok ka na dito sa concept. Derila kay Shadow. At least ano. Wala di naka-online ngayon ako tapos nang pinambuli ako tapos mga estudyante. Okay, so they are, ano, they are more likely die of prostate cancer than in men in other racial or ethnic groups. So as mentioned earlier, African-American men are 1.6 times more likely than white men to develop prostate cancer. And they are 2.4 times more likely to die from this disease as compared to white men. So possible risk factors that may explain the increased mortality rate in African American men include their lower engagement in healthcare system, disparities in healthcare, and cultural and structural constraints. So there's nothing to do with the physiology. There's nothing to do with the physiology or the structure of the body or the complexion. So it's more credited on how they take care of themselves kasi nga may sinasabi nating based on their cultural background. Okay, next risk factor. So we have the age. Ito yung pinaka-common guys na age, pinaka-common na risk factor for breast cancer. Kung masabi natin common or common denominator yung ano yung gender kasi nga mas common yung babae. So dito naman, ito yung pinaka-common. So this is the age. So prostate cancer is rare for age under 40 years old. Yan. So kung halimbawa ma-diagnose ng prostate cancer, paki-check pa ka naman hindi siya prostate cancer. So while it is common in older than 80 years of age, so as a matter of fact, some studies have suggested that among men over 80 years of age, 50 to 80% of them may have prostate cancer. And more than 80% of prostate cancers are diagnosed in men older than 65 years of age. So boys, ano pa? Safe pa, safe. Yan, lilipay na lang tayo. Yeah. So common denominator natin or common risk factor is the age. So mostly, ang mga nagkaka-prostate cancer based sa ating sabuk is mga arog na. Ano? So pag mag-ano na, pag mag-edad ng 60 or 65 or 80, so di na mag-expect. Yan? Common risk factor is yan. Diba? Pag mag-age siya nga 80 years and above, so more likely nagkakaroon ng prostate cancer ang isang lalaki. So that's why sabi natin kanina, Well, hindi pa naman tapos yung lecture. So, wala akong nakita ditong other risk factor na mahilig magmat. Okay, so next we have the genetics. So, a familial predisposition may occur in men who have a father or a brother previously diagnosed with prostate cancer, especially if their relatives were diagnosed at young age. So, itong gene na to, di ba? The BRCA2 gene. Okay, so nag-appear siya dati sa ating lecture doon sa male prostate cancer, male breast cancer. So ito yung pinaka-credited, no? Pinaka-babantayan. So kaya pag halimbawa newborn screening, babantayan dapat yung BRCA2 gene. So the increased risk of prostate cancer. Next, environmental factors, of course. So although still unproven, so environmental factors such as cigarette smoking, and diets that are high in saturated fat. Okay, mga buro barbecue, kaya Oreo, ay pag kinangkunin mga buro barbecue, dida mga liquid, ba? Ay, katan mga gimbabalig yan, mga kanto-kanto nga mga barbecue because this is high in saturated fat or mga processed meats. Okay, so these are common risk factors for prostate cancer. Seem to increase the risk of prostate cancer. There is also a suggestion that there's also a suggestion that obesity leads to an increased risk of having a more aggressive, a larger cancer, which results in poorer outcome and treatment. Kaya guys, kami sa BSRT, wow, sa BSRT department, walang mataraba dito, di ba? Hurry kami mga po. Ito, isa sa mga qualifications namin dito sa BSRT, kailangan walang mataba sa amin. O, diba? So kita niyo naman walang masyadong obese sa amin. Hindi lang sa aming mga boys, ay hindi kayo na ko sure. So dire kami mga obese. Didisregard na muna option ng obesity kasi we tend to, 'di ba? We are in the College of Nursing and Allied Health Sciences. 'Di ba na? Bagaw pa ibang mga taga-college. Ano ba ini nga mga taga-nursing, mga magtambok man ini, dire-dire maaram niya, ang tayo mismo puan. Tayo mismo taada health, ang tayo mismo tagiging conscious it era body. So then on. Okay, so obesity is one of the risk factors for or one of the environmental factors for prostate cancer. What else? Additional substances or toxins in the environment or from industrial sources might also promote the development of prostate cancer, but these have not yet been clearly identified. So yun lang, di ba? So nakita niyo, di ba? Wara man na aton references nga kung ano, kung mahilig magmasurbate, waray asawa, waray ganit, damon asawa. So waray man dida, waray man niya ma-record. Yun lang, kung halimbawa, damo tiya sexual partners, ang main problema natin dyan is HIV. So, posible di rin mamatay prostate cancer, but pwede siya mamatay. Pwede siya mamatay with other, mga AIDS. Diba? HIV AIDS. So, wala sa ating references nga. Again, kaya ipagpatuloy nyo yung mga ginagawa nyo every night, guys. Sorry. Kaya kung yun na ito naging bisyo, so make sure lang na itbong-bong ito yung kwarto kompleto pa ha, dire kay mga nagluluho-luho na. Yan ito yung kamot, kailangan dire pa masyado magaspang. So yun, wala sa ating mga references nga. Yun lang yung mga sinabi dyan. No? So again, race, what else? The age, of course, your gene, genetics, and environmental factors. Yun lang mga nasabing risk factors for prostate cancer. Lurali po tira istadihan dere. Palabaon ta kay may dapat niyo istadihan. You need to study on renal and urinary bladder cancer. Sunan niyo yun. Ayun, madali po ito ang chapter test next week. Hindi pa tayo tapos. No? So, kailangan pahalabaon pa okay, para at least damot iyo coverage para final exam. Okay, what else? We have the clinical manifestations. Ang pangilalaan nga itong lalaki, may dananiya prostate cancer. So, cancer of the prostate in its early stages rarely produces symptoms. Early stages, wala. Ano? So, the symptoms that develop from urinary obstruction occur late in the age or in the disease. So, sabi natin, makikita or nagmamanifest na, nagkakamya din ng mga symptoms kung either stage 3 or stage 4. This cancer tends to vary in its course. So if the neoplasm is large enough to encroach the bladder neck, so of course, ito yung magiging signs and symptoms are urinary obstruction, kinukurian pag-ihi. Kaya pag kita ultrasound, aboy, kaya naka-ano man niya, naka-encroach na nakakahuot dito ang urinary bladder. So, associated with it is difficulty and frequency of urination, ito ang urinary retention, and the decreased size and force of urinary stream. Okay, I guess I don't have to explain in detail on these things. So, other symptoms may include blood in the urine. So, tawag natin dyan, hematuria, di ba? Hema means blood, urea. So, blood in the urine. Blood in the urine or semen and ejaculation. So, hematuria may result in the cancer if the cancer invades the urethra or bladder or both. So, next, other than that, so ito yung mga other symptoms. Prostate cancer can metastasize to bone, to lymph and lymph nodes. So symptoms related to metastasis include backache, which it is not related to position. So masyong nga, nagsinuol man nakikod, tapos hindi man kayo itong, parang makinimo kanina na ano man lang, ganun. So hip pain, again, it's not related to activity. Nagsuol na lang yung mga hips. Perineal and rectal discomfort. Anemia, weight loss, weakness, nausea, and oliguria. What's oliguria? You know? May maka-answer nga di. Maka-answer nga niya, dire kami plus ha. Sige daw, what's oliguria? Oliguria. Sige. Dito ila ang urine output. Mm-hmm. At anong sugod ni Balasta? Anong sugod ni Balasta? Ah, oh, pala ko ba? Buti laan na iihi. Dito laan na iihi. So, yun. So, parang nagpapatak-patak nala. Parang patak-patak nala ang iihi. So, that's oliguria. Kadali lang. So, these are the signs. But again, bahing ka mo, nakakaabot na ka mo at your age, hindi pa man siguro. Parang masyadong early magka-prostate cancer. Parang manato ng age, di ba? An age bracket. Usually, again, 60 or higher ang potential suspect na may prostate cancer ka. So, yun. Next, we have the diagnostic procedures. Kasi sa breast cancer kasi may tinatawag tayo na screening, di ba? Screening for breast cancer. So here, wala tayong tinatawag na screening. O, aray ni Masawan nga. Hindi daw, magpa-ano na daw kita, magpa-examine na daw kita prostate, ba yun, ganun. Waray screening para mga lalaki. Unlike sa mga girls, may screening niyo. So pagka age niyo ng 40, pwede na ka magpamamogram to check. Or limbawa, when you are still younger, 20 to 30, pwede na magpa-CBE or BSE, di ba? Pa-examine ng suso, ganun. O pwede na, halimbawa, kung ikaw sexually active, pwede ka magpa-physical exam. Dito kasi sa mga lalaki, wala kaming tinatawag na screening. So the DRE or the digital rectal examination, this is recommended as part of regular health checkup for every man older than 40 years of age. But oh, mag-i-enjoy ni Gaspan, DRE, digital rectal exam. Mahinuhulat niya. Oh, may da ka na ano. May da ka na chance, Mr. Gaspan. So the DRE, this is again, this enable the examiner to assess the size, the shape, and consistency of the prostate gland. So ayun, kung nakikita naman niyo, parang Annabel Raman. Kita niyo naman, di ba? Okay. So, gloved hand, tapos isisingit, erectal. So, i-insert, nga diha, rectum, anus. Okay, tapos kakapaunan, an-anich, prostate. Yan. So again, the DRE enable the examiner to assess the size, the shape, and consistency of the prostate gland. So any tenderness of the prostate gland on palpation and the presence and consistency of any nodules are noted. So although this examination may be embarrassing for the patient, so it is important screening tool. So may dito nag-istorya ako ng balay, ano? Like an mga nag-a-apply, I'm not sure ha, may story man lang yung mga nag-a-apply ng ano seaman ano kon before daw raman pas sa barko kailangan gin nagpapa DRE ganun. So ayan, nakita niyo nang exam, tapos ano yung bagin papa ini-evaluate an era ano scrotum kay possibly may ano may hernia. And so part of the evaluation ni ano, oh, di ba Gaspan natawa, nag-enjoy siya aton DRE. Perfect na ini siya chapter test next week. So yan. Next we have the PSA. Direkta ng Statistics Office. PSA, or this is the prostate specific antigen test. So this is the procedure, or the prostate gland produces a substance known as the PSA. So it can be measured in blood specimen, and levels increase with PSA with prostate cancer. So a number of conditions, kung ano ba magpa PSA ka, so kung ano ba nag-increase ano direkta pwede prostate cancer ka dayon. So pwede di ba benign prostatic hyperplasia, transurethral resection of the prostate, acute urinary retention, acute prostatitis can cause elevated PSA in the absence of prostate cancer. Kaya di rin natin masusugad nga ano siya gold standard for ano for prostate cancer screening. So here we can say okay, pwede ka siya maging prostate cancer screening, but again, dire siya parehasan otras an mamo nga talagang pwede siya maging gold standard. So prostate cancer screening with serum PSA testing has become common practice. So an annual PSA test along with yan. So kailangan magpa-PSA ka nga ni may kaupod nga DRE. No. So PSA along with DRE is recommended by the American Cancer Society for men at higher risk, including those with a family history of prostate cancer. So PSA is also useful to monitor patients with recurrence after treatment for cancer of the prostate based on the evidence-based algorithms. Tanbang, may mga changes, tapos hindi kita ni Rama, pinkon, anong mga changes. So, and yung algorithms, pwede mag-indicate nga, oh, nag-record na naman ang prostate cancer. Din. Next, we have the ultrasonography. Hello, mag-i-enjoy talaga na liwat ni Gaspon. So, ultrasound. For the prostate, makuri man iniigkuan, usually, oh, pwede gan siya, ano, pwede gan siya, routine nga KUB. Routine nga KUB, kaya syempre, this is quite embarrassing for ang mga lalaking magpapa transrectal ultrasound. But, okay, so kung nagro-rule out kita, if our diagnosis would indicate na talagang prostate cancer in ano gusto mama or suspected with prostate cancer, so transrectal ultrasound may be performed. So transrectal ultrasound, so if you can see The transducer is inserted in the rectum. Okay. So, this is with patients with abnormalities detected, may nakapasa DRE sa digital rectal exam, and those with elevated PSA. So, kunwari indication, wag na lang muna. Pwede pagpaano na lang, routine na KUB ultrasound. So, after DRE has been completed, common condom-covered rectal probe is inserted into the rectum along with the anterior wall. So, the transrectal ultrasound may be used in detecting non-palpable prostate cancers and in staging localized prostate cancer. So, after which, pwede na mag-conduct ng biopsies. So, needle biopsies of the prostate are commonly guided by transrectal ultrasound. Yun naman pala. So, maging usually the high indication for ano for transrectal ultrasound is because kailangan mag-conduct liwat ng ano ng needle ultrasound guided biopsy. Okay. Next up, we have the clinical management. Okay, so guys, kadali lang ha. Can we have a break muna? Ako lang kung ano, if you want to stay there, mas maupay kay pagbalik ko mag-check out attendance kay. I feel like ano, I need to drink water. So stay there. Say hi. Okay, so attendance muna tayo, guys. Bengka malipat ha, dirito ni Tina, nakikita nga da camera, dirito ni ako. Muli ba kayo, Jean, mila ka na naka-document ko na, oh. Do ka dito, nakikita ko. Full screen, yan, so sige. Oh, sana wala dere era balay na nang matulog lo. Sige. 1, 2, 3, and smile. Yan. Sige na, ito ka na. Ito ka na, yung paigas ng ayam. Okay, sige. So, thank you so much. Ang tinatawag, kailangan, ang tinatawag, ang kailangan from start to end it aton discussion. Ano, may attendance. Okay, yan. Attendance 2. Tangkula iyo po an. Sa iyo classroom. Para at least naman tiyo effort. Diri sayang kayo separate na papaload ka. Mayroon sa rin yung chacha. Okay, nandun na. So tapos ang talaga na ikon hatang discussion with prostate cancer. So it's quite ano lang siya. It's quite halipot lang compared with other cancers. So next week we will discuss the renal and urinary bladder cancer. Tapos kahuman na ito, the following week, tsaka pa lang tayo magkakamaya din chapter test. Parang sad ka man, Miss Luca, pang wala kita chapter test next week. Gusto mo may da? So... So, tsaka pa lang mga kay next week, you will be, ano, you will be quite busy. Tama ba tayo, guys? Busy ba tayo next week? Kasi may ano na tayo, mag-start na kita mag-screening for internship. So, we will have the qualifying exam, practical part. So, pag-usapan muna natin yon. Okay, so, may rubrics man kita, ano, so, it's more, ano niya, more of, kung ano siya, parang clinical application. So, you need to check the patient, ano yung require nga position, tapos, mag-provide ako yung film. So, part yon ng, ano, ng anatomy. Halimbawa, yung makita mong clinical history dito ni patient. So, i-review tani yung anatomy, i-review natin yung medical terminology, di ba? So, limbawa, ang request dito, nakabutang CVA. So, ano kaya rin singunit CVA? Di ba? So, mga ganun ba? So, nakabutang dito ng STAT. Ano kaya rin singunit STAT? So, yun. Part yan ang pag-review natin sa ano sa practical exam. More on pan hospital na siya kay internship. Alam man ito pan redem lang niyo yung I am kegeme ganun. So kailangan expected din ni maram na kamo position, maram na kamo rule out, maram na kamo han ganun. As in you can identify now what is the difference between Bennett's fracture and Baxter's fracture. Di ba mga ganun? So, you need to establish guidelines. See you soon, guys, sa mental hospital. Uy, kaya ano, magkano ka nga ito, ano, Christy? Magkano ka? Mabisita na laak. Hotel pa naman Manila. Manila nga Cebula pa naman may mental hospital. O rin mental nga di at Tacloban. Kala ka mo. Otherwise, magkano ka mo? Magpapalaboy-laboy ka makali. So we need to review your ano. Yes, Miss Banzon, you want to say something?
Wala ka po sir na tindot. Sorry po.
Parang hindi ko naririnig.
Sir, napindot lang po. Sorry.
Paki-chat na daw, di ko maano, di ko mabati, auntie mo. Ow! Kala ko you were asking something. Okay, yun. So, see you next week. May din naman kita schedule, ano. So, yun ang mga kailangan nating identify. So we okay. are expecting, ano, we want to produce interns for the incoming for the incoming school year. So, of course, RadTech interns, dari secretary, dari marites, so RadTech intern tamang kailangan. So, lahat ng mga napag-aralan nyo when it comes to positioning, when it comes to anatomy, of course, medical terminology, pathology. So you need to review. We need to incorporate all of these things sa ano sa ating practical exam. Yes, Miss De La Cruz. Certain na po na projections. Basta ano, basta general positioning. Mostly ano, extremities. Diba, next week ang ating pag ano at aton positioning most sa ano lang upper and lower extremities, vertebral column, chest, abdomen, pelvic, ganun. So anything, everything, general diagnostics. So okay na kita. Okay, sige. See you next week. See you next week. See you the next 2 weeks. Okay, so para ano, para mas ma-hapsaya namon process yan na for internship qualifying, dire kami nag-aapura liwat. Sir, may ginbubunot. Of course. So here, ganito, dire ko gusto, I don't want to say. Okay, so, mabunot, let's say your patient, bubunotin natin dito, di rin ang magahin AP, di rin ganun. Atan, ano siya, atan, I will provide, ano, mga x-ray requests. So, sa x-ray request, nandun yung, ano, yung, halimbawa, ano yung history ng patient, bakit i-x-ray. So, halimbawa, kung nakabutang dito, CVA. So, una question ko ay, sige, what is CVA? Ganun ba? Kung nakabutang dito, stat. Sige daw, kanon stat? So, po, apart ito pag-grado namon, nakon, x-ray request. Kanon itong, naka, ano siya, VA, MVA patient. So, what's MVA? Ganun ba? Kailangan maaram kita ito. Support yun. So, ma-provide ako yun parang x-ray request. So, may, ano dito, may history ng patient. Kaya diba, ano, na-cry ka man, miss go. So, diba, mag-x-ray kita, kailangan kita man natin history. So, kung nalimbawa, kung ang history ni patient, okay, kapag ang dito, ano siya, PTB. What is PTB? Yung mga ganun ba, mga basic questions. Why are you so sad? Scare. Oh, quite some point scary kay mga ano na siya, mga x-ray request. Okay, so I hope you are already preparing for that. Sir, titiguan na mo ang kailangan. Dire, I'm going to ano. There's already now the projection or the procedure. Halimbawa, nakabutang dito. CXRPA. Okay, tapos, an history, ganito yung patient. Tapos, I will provide x-ray film. So, what pathology can you see? Is the history correct with the, ano, is your diagnosis as RadTech correct with the, what's written on the, ano, on the history? Or, ano ba, yung nakaka-coincide ba, ganun? So, yun lang naman. Halimbawa, mapakiana ko dito, Bennett's fracture. So, tama ba? Itong film ba to ay Bennett's fracture? Itong film na to ay Boxer's fracture. No? Okay. Ito ba ay isang Gilyazis fracture? Mga ganun. So, yun, mga kailangan yung tandaan. No? Okay. So meaning your concern is not only with ano, kasi RadTech itatong yung proposals din ni. So your concern is not just positioning, of course, positioning is given kasi nga theoretical. But of course, we need to evaluate then the anatomy, the pathology, the history ng patient, ganun ganyan guys, no? Okay. So ano pa, may pakialam pa before I proceed? Ganun, di ba? Parang nagiging exciting ang labanan. Ayun, so parang wala ng questions. Okay, by partner ito ni sir. Yes po, by partner, pero an pag-grad, of course, kuan man ito siya, di ba, ito, matawag lang ako, someone nga ma-act nga patient. Kung halimbawa, 105 ng student, sige, you're the patient. So, ikaw tigpo-position. But ang pag-graduan ko, of course, ikaw lang. Or, tingnan na lang natin next week what will happen kung ano kay. Actually, I'm not so confident din with ano with with third year kay nagtututok doon na huring. May pa rin ang ganun. So, kita na lang next week basta you will not be ano, you'll not be doing the imaginary one. So you'll be doing the actual one. Kaya ano. Okay, sige. Good luck kayo, tanan. I hope there is sumakit ang ulo. Okay, welcome. I hope there is sumakit ang ulo next week. Ay, ko, gano'n ba ini? Ito na na, di ka pa maaram. Di ka pa maaram kung pera at carpal bones. Ano ba yan? Di ba? ano ba yan? Di ka pa maaram? Eh, ito, kuan, medially located. Di ka pa maaram kung sinasirang nga bagus ngayon. Valgus, my God. Mag-i-intern ka. Di rin masugadah na sinaton scenario next week. Kung ta, di rin sinungad. I hope you are doing your part because you want to nag-apply ka mo for internship. Okay? Okay, so sige. Good luck kayo nga tanan. And tomorrow, Jasmine, si Resin at makadto sa college. So we will have our dry run. And on Saturday, we have our webinar, yan, entitled, Looking Good, Am I Right? Wow, I appreciate now, kay damo yan ang nagpa-interview. Sana all may brown eyes, at sana all, so attractive ang heart. Ang iba kasi dyan, hindi ko alam. Okay, sige, let's continue. So those are the diagnostic procedures for prostate cancers. Now, let's come to the clinical management. So here, treatment is based on the stage of the disease and the patient's age and symptoms. Kay, you know, mostly ang nagkaka-prostate cancer, mga arog, no? So, makuri man ito, masugad nga, operahan siya dahil. Operahan siya. Kasi, halimbawa, 90 years old, operahan mo ba, lugod siya, masukday with the operation. So, di ba? So, inidetermine muna liwat ito naton and ano, and condition ni patient. Kaya arog na, di, maswag nga. 95 years old, kaya't iba nga nito, papabayan nala. Di ba? Masing 50 years old, pwede operahan. Di ba? Depende again. Nakadepende siya at iya age and iya symptoms nga gindadara. So treatment is often guided by use of nomogram. So nomograms are instrument based on multiple variables. Sana all nagkakapi that are used to calculate the predicted probability that a patient will have a specified outcome. So incorporation of data from clinical assessment, laboratory test, and transrectal ultrasound into a pre-biopsy nomogram significantly improves the prediction. Parang nag-ano lang ba? Parang minsan naghuhula-hula. Ano. Pero may mga bases, may mga nomograms, may mga indication based on mga laboratory exams. So, it reduces the number of unnecessary prostate biopsies and assess the treatment decision. So, here, ginilimitahan ang pag-biopsy. No? So, gini-evaluate naton ang So parang nag-ano ba, parang nag-jive na o nag-jump na into conclusion nga ay prostate cancer siya. Diba? Kung nakita natin na natin notes, natin lecture, wala dito prostate biopsy, diba? Nagkakamaya na kita yung nomogram. So based sa kanyang DRE, based sa kanyang PSA, based sa kanyang transrectal ultrasound. So all of these things, ginhalalon. Okay, so sige, ayun, okay, prostate cancer siya. Kaya ano, gini-eliminate natin ang prostate cancer ng biopsy. Take note, again, mga arug na itong pasyente nga nagkakamenda mostly in prostate cancer. Kaya mostly, ang ginihin mo din, gini-eliminate ang possibility nga may biopsy. Parang pagtanggal, sayuan la, ano, tanggal kayo. Kaya pagbabiopsy ka, halimbawa, fine needle, sukun, tas mako. Anyway, pwede man tayo mo on with, ano, with TRUS, with transrectal ultrasound. Iga-guide mo ang imo needle with biopsy. Okay, okay, next up. Okay, so we have the surgical management. So radical prostatectomy. Hindi na lahat itong mga radical. So dire-dire pag naming it nomenclature nato na no dire-dire kay prostatectomy. Damo nga yan. So we have radical prostatectomy. So this is the complete surgical removal of the prostate, seminal vesicles, the tips of the vas deferens and the surrounding fat, nerves and blood vessels. So dire la kay ang prostate ang gintanggal, radical prostatectomy. So it is considered the standard first line of treatment for prostate cancer. So kung magsugad ng prostate cancer, ang may isip agad is radical prostatectomy. So we also have the laparoscopic radical prostatectomy. So ini magamit in laparoscope. So this is a new approach to surgical treatment of localized cancer of the prostate. However, because the technique has been performed for only a few years, data regarding long-term cancer control and functional results are not available, although sexual impotence follows radical prostatectomy. So laparoscopic radical prostatectomy offers advantages of low morbidity and favorable postoperative outcomes, including the quality of life. So, we also have the hormonal therapy. So, newer hormonal therapy include the luteinizing hormone, releasing hormone, LHRH, at least di dano may RH. So, mga hilig uminom dyan. So, agonist like prolide and guserilin and anti-androgen agents such as glutamide. So, the luteinizing hormone, releasing hormone, suppresses testicular androgen, whereas glutamide causes adrenal androgen suppression. And the most common uses of LHRH agonist are the following. So, pwede magpa-hormonal therapy. So, in the adjuvant and neoadjuvant setting before hormonal suppressive agent and in combination with radical prostatectomy and in a treatment of recurrence indicated by elevated PSA. So, kung bumalik ka niya prostate cancer, okay, LHRH. But without clinical or X-ray evidence. So we also have chemotherapy. Okay, so this is the perks of doing classes online. Adilabala, syempre nakakapagkapi ka, di ba? Lalo na sa mga ano, sa mga... Ay! Ala, sorry, I was doing the ano. Kuna ko kasi nakas-share screen. I'm so sorry. I thought naka-share screen up. Ayun. Ayan, sorry. So ito yung mga pinagsasabi natin kanina. Okay, so we have the surgical. So the dalawa lang naman. We have radical and laparoscopic prostatectomy, okay, and we have the hormonal and we have the chemotherapy. So here in chemotherapy, okay, so it have shown clear benefits in terms of survival. Pinala nung agini or exit ko taku ang tak screen. I'm exiting my screen kay para sir what I post screen ngayon. Sorry. Okay, so thank you so much. So we have the chemotherapy. So recent studies have shown clear benefits in terms of survival with chemotherapy treatment. That includes yun yung mga chemotherapy drugs na pwedeng gamitin for chemotherapy. We have paclitaxel for non-androgen-dependent prostate cancer. So other studies are underway to determine importance of vascular endothelial growth factor system. So tumor angiogenesis is essential for tumor growth, including growth of prostate carcinomas and other high-grade cancers. So therefore, anti-angiogenic treatment in combination with conventional therapies may play a future role in treatment. So a genetic-based therapy in the prostate cancer is an emerging and promising adjuvant to conventional treatment strategies. Next, we have the cryosurgery. Cryo meaning if you're frozen muna. Parang ano, parang karne. Parang karne nga, ibubutang mo muna sa freezer, tapos kaman mo yung freezer, di-defrost, tapos dito nakatagtaron. Yan, cryosurgery tawag ito. So for cryosurgery, so cryosurgery of the prostate is used to ablate. Ablate, parang susunog talaga, no? Prostate cancer in patients who cannot tolerate surgery. Tamat option, ano, kung di rekayan surgery, pwede cryosurgery. Surgery pa din. And in those with current prostate cancers. So transperineal probes are inserted into the prostate under ultrasound guidance to freeze the tissue directly. And chemotherapy agents may also be used. So parang ano yan, guys? Parang tutusukon mo ang prostate, pero kailangan para makasugad kang prostate ang natit na naiigo. So naka-ultrasound. So a needle, yung kikita mo using ultrasound. And then pag makita na nga ayun prostate na. So dida i-inject na an bang consort yung bastos sa. I-inject na dida an ano an helium nitrogen. Tapos talagang papaano siya, papabagtikon ang prostate. Yan, so that's cryosurgery. Next. Okay. So we have radiation therapy. Okay, of course, ang matatun na subject. So if prostate cancer is detected in early stage, so the treatment may be curative. Yan. So two major forms of radiation therapy are used to treat cancer of the prostate. So we have teletherapy and pwede brachytherapy. Diba? So prostate cancer treatment with radiotherapy has dramatically changed over the last 15 years with the implementation of conformal and more recently intensity modulated radiation therapy or the IMRT techniques. So the treatment philosophy of prostatic carcinoma is quite complex. So we need to check first the nomogram, no, with the introduction of prostate-specific antigen test. So the tissue has become further compounded. So surgery, radiation therapy, and hormonal manipulation are alit mga ano mga primary treatment ng prostate cancer. Okay, so the treatment depends largely on the patient's age, balik-balik ano, stage and differentiation of the tumor, the PSA level, underlying medical problems, and patient's preference. Kagustuhan ni pasyente. Kaya ba yung nadiri pasyente? Nga, igrantera, may mahimo kay ton. Diba? So, when the tumor is confined to the prostate, the treatment usually consists of radiation therapy or radical prostatectomy, which we have mentioned earlier, and if the tumor is felt to have penetrated the capsule or to involve the seminal vesicles, hindi ipapasok si radiation therapy. Kailan? Kung, again, so if the tumor is felt to have penetrated the capsule or involved the seminal vesicles. So most patients with prostate carcinoma who have positive regional lymph nodes are incurable. Kita nyo? Dire siya mas, di ba? Nagsugad na natong libro. Dire siya makukure. So most patients with prostate carcinoma who have positive regional lymph nodes are incurable and are not offered definitive radiotherapy. So palliative ang ato ni himuon. So radiation therapy of the prostate carcinoma is usually delivered via external beam radiotherapy alone, but in some institution, so pwede mag-brachy, interstitial radiation. This is employed either as primary therapy, usually in conjunction with lymph node dissection, or to deliver boost to prostate gland. Diba, sabi natin last time, pag magsugat nga nga boost, diba usually brachy. Diba? Ang okay mo on. So locally advanced prostatic cancer is sometimes managed with regimen consisting of external beam therapy followed by brachytherapy and gubutangan pa interstitial hyperthermia or with neoadjuvant androgen deprivation. So una, external beam, kaduha, magbabraki, kay bu-boost, katulo, ibutan natin implant, no? So, at least, ano, dire ganun ka, kuri kay saan ka ng mga babae nga tanan. So, external beam radiotherapy of early stage prostate carcinoma involves the treatment of the prostate gland, the vesicles or seminal vesicles, and periprostatic tissues to approximately 6,000 centigrade, followed by a boost to the prostate gland, 6,800 to 7,000 centigrade. Yan yung mga kailangang tandaan natin dyan, guys. Yung mga dose ng radiation. Kailangan daw mga tatandaan. Ano? So, in advanced stage disease, palliative. Okay, di rin naman makikure. So, palliative irradiation. Of the entire pelvis to approximately 5,000 centigrade, followed by a boost to the prostate gland may be given. And the four-field box technique described in the treatment of gynae, di ba, L5S1, L5L4, tapos adi sa may obturator foramen, is also often used in the treatment of prostate cancer, and the treatment simulation procedure, therefore, is similar. So, remember guys, for those who wanted to have the internship at Jose Arreyes Memorial Medical Center. So you will have your pre-internship for 2 weeks at the Eastern Visayas Medical Center dedicated only for CT scan. So that when you arrive at the radiation therapy department for your internship proper, so you already have a background knowledge on the CT scan. So yun, kailangan may damo na kita, aram muna natin mag CT scan before we can handle CT simulation. Again, the planning is also the same for those of the gynecologic cancers. Kaya nasin kita kanina, bulos ka mo din ni girls. So in the treatment of advanced disease, okay, where the whole pelvis is treated, the inferior border encompasses the inferior border of the prostate with 1.5 to 2 centimeter margin and is usually at the inferior aspect of the ischial tuberosity. So if this is your pelvis, tama ba pagka-drawing? Pelvic rim. Ay, pangit. Ayan. So, anan bagaw? So, ma-extend kita for 1.5 to 2 centimeter inferior to the ischial tuberosity. If this is your ischium, so ma-extend tayo ng 1.5 to 2 centimeter to the ischial tuberosity. And the cephalad margin usually include, gaya ng sinabi natin kanina, gaya ng sagaini, na nasa L4, L5, or L5S1. And the lateral borders include the bony pelvis with 1.5 to 2 centimeter margin. So, ang target natin, parang pelvic din, ano? Yan. So, the lateral fields should have the same caudad and cephalad extent. L4, L5. Yan. Tapos, 1.5 to 2 centimeter inferior of the ischial tuberosity. Okay, so the lateral have the same caudad and cephalad extent. And the anterior foot. Posterior field. So, the anterior margin should include the bony pelvis and the posterior margin should transect the rectum. Okay, so if this is the okay naka side view. So the bony pelvis, didang nga part, tapos sa may rectum. So nakita niyo kaya four field box type. Okay, ni anterior, anterior posterior. Yan, bahala na lang kami dapat ano. So, iyon, AP. Adi, unlateral. Okay? So, the fields should be shaped to avoid large volumes of the small bowel. Remember that this one, this is highly radiosensitive, rectum and bladder. So, the treatment of these fields is often followed by boost to the prostate. So radical prostate irradiation is usually delivered via smaller fields that include the prostate gland, the seminal vesicles, and the prostatic tissues. What else? So many different techniques for the treatment of prostate cancer have been described using arc and rotation techniques, often used in combination with a four-field stationary field. So with the availability of improved methods to localize the target, such as magamit ng CT and MRI, and the three-dimension treatment planning, allowing more complex field arrangements, better sparing of normal tissues can be achieved. So may din natong tinatawag, aside from the four field box technique, so may arc and rotational technique that's dedicated for prostate cancer. So a six field. Oh, aside from four field, aside from the arc and rotational, may tayo six field technique using opposed lateral obliques. Yan. May mga oblique na ibubutang. So aside from AP, aside from lateral, so magbubutang kita di hinduha ka oblique. Kaya matawag natin nga six field. No? So iga-angle naton 45 degrees with respect to the lateral fields has been described by Ten Haken. This is a non-coplanar, so multiple field technique which includes lateral fields and two anterior field, inferior oblique fields has also been described. So in treatment technique described by Bijold et al. And Libisk et al. So the boost with the prostate gland is delivered simultaneously with large field treatment during the same few minutes of the treatment. Okay, so a partial transmission block is used to the portion of the large field so that, a partial transmission block is used in the portions of the large field that are receive a lower dose, while the segment that is to receive a higher dose remains unobstructed without attenuating device. So the favored treatment technique is external beam radiotherapy of the prostate. This remains a four-field box technique. Ang daming sinabi, ano? Daming sinabi kanina, may four-field, may six field, okay, it remains as a four field box technique, primarily because of ease in the setup and review of portal films. Okay, so high energy that is greater than 6 megavolt photon beams should be used to keep the dose in the dose of the femoral head and the femoral head and the femoral neck low. So, kung kitaon natin, mas ataas ang gagamitin na photon, to keep the dose in the dose of the femoral head and neck low. Ganun pala yun. Okay, so the anterior and posterior fields include the entire urinary bladder and rectum. So, exposed lang muna. So, diba? Expose ka lang muna with radiation. Patiinin. Expose ka lang muna with radiation. But it should exclude the femoral head and the femoral neck. So the lateral fields on the other hand include the femoral head. Kitaon niyo ha? Anterior. Sunog ka lang muna. Lateral. Sunog ka lang muna. but exclude large sections of the bladder and rectum. So the combined dose distribution of delivering 5,000 centigrade to the larger fields and 2,000 centigrade to the prostate boost was shown. Refer to your book. Okay, so let's come to, oh my God, this is the last part. The side effects of radiation therapy, these are usually transitory. This include inflammation of the rectum, the bowel, and the urinary bladder. So, proctitis, inflammation of the rectum. Enteritis, the bowel. Cystitis, urinary bladder. This is due to their proximity to the prostate and radiation doses. Buti na lang hindi, walang ano, walang inflammation ng femoral head and femoral neck. So irritation of the bladder and urethra from the radiation therapy can cause pain with urination and during the ejaculation until the irritation subsides. However, there is greater preservative of sexual. Oh, kailangan mas maupay ko na igradera kay greater preservation of sexual potency. Eh, kung gusto pa niya manganak, pwede pa because of radiation therapy. Diba? Eh, kung surgery, tatanggalon man. Iwaray na. Iwaray na. So, for patients with clinically localized but high-risk prostate cancer, multimodal treatment may result in improved cancer control. So, in patients with larger tumors, combination therapy, this usually include radiation therapy muna, followed by hormonal therapy, may improve overall survival. So, yun. So, that ends our discussion with prostate cancer. Ayun. So, do you have any question, guys? Alam, wala yung rapakian na, kaya feeling ko naman ang galing-galing kong teacher. Nahalaban na lahat po. Nahalaban, nadako na lahat buo. Charit. Okay, so if there are no questions, then let us check your attendance for the last time, for the sake of plus five. For the sake of plus five, stop presenting. Ano na ito? Parang mga haggard naman ka. Mori pa nga ni kita magtikangan ang exciting na part. Okay, so for the last time, let's check your attendance. That's, oh, yan ang kadaliha. I'm going to have a full screen view. Ano na siya? May dungay, may dungay ibang audience. Parokan video. May dungay ang nagkikita tak lecture. Tapos, ano pa naman tak mga wordings. Okay, para makarelate, di ba? Kaya kung maarog na imo, iyo, Papa, Papa, you're already 80 years old, so you're already prone to prostate cancer. So you already, pati you mga parents, they will have an idea on how to, char. Kaya naman, tira na lecture. Okay, sige, ang dami ko pang daldal. Sige, so for the last time, look into the camera in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, smile. Okay, thank you so much, guys. So, see you next week for our part 2 of the internship evaluation or qualifying examination, which is on the practical side. So if there are no questions, so you may now leave our meeting. So class